Hey guys, welcome back to another video on my cooking channel. On this week's video, we are gonna be talking about poaching.
Not that type of poaching. Also, aren't you vegan? Hello everybody, welcome back to another video on my channel. My name is Adam, also known as the Pickleball Guy. And in this week's video, we're gonna be talking about a skill that a lot of players don't utilize at all in their pickleball game, but can be super helpful to really elevating you to the next level, poaching. So poaching refers to when one player steps into the other side of the court to hit a shot that their partner would have otherwise hit. It most commonly happens in three scenarios. Although the goal in pickleball is for both partners to get up to the net, there are times where that's not going to happen. So in this scenario, if I'm at the net but my partner's back, I can kind of help them out by potentially stepping over and hitting a volley that would have otherwise been their shot. If both partners are at the net and my opponents hit a shot that might be a sort of tougher backhand for my partner, albeit in their side of the court, I can maybe step over and hit a really aggressive forehand for us to have a better chance to win that point. The final scenario, while not very common, can be super successful if we can kind of trick our opponents and mix in a poach every now and again in order to better have a chance at winning that point. In this scenario, your partner as the serve returner is going to hit that return of serve and look as if they're slow coming up to the net. When your opponents try to capitalize on that by hitting a ball to your partner's side of the court, you at the net are going to jump over, poach that shot, and your partner is now going to go diagonally and they are going to occupy the space that you were just occupying on the court.
So what should I do if my partner poaches?
If your partner does poach, you should take the spot that they were just occupying so that way you're not both stuck on the same side of the court.
Of all the different poaching scenarios, which is the best to learn?
So I would recommend practicing scenario number 2 where you and your partner are both at the net and you poach a shot that would be a backhand for your partner. This is a scenario that I just see generally working the most often. So if you can really master that, your pickleball game is going to improve tremendously.
Are poached eggs the best type of eggs?
No, of course not. Hey guys, super quick pause to the video. Want to let you know that I'm so excited to announce my brand new partnership with The Kitchen. They're the fastest growing pickleball community in the entire world right now. You can find them by searching The Kitchen Pickleball on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. Thank you guys so much. You do not want to miss their content. Okay, now back to the video. When practicing poaching, it really is all about syncing up you and your partner's movements so that way the moment you go to poach, your partner knows exactly where to be on the court and you guys are always positioned perfectly. So for this drill, you and a partner are both gonna start at the net and somebody on the other side is gonna toss a shot that would be to your partner's backhand volley. Every single point, you're gonna decide whether or not you wanna poach that shot. If you do decide to poach, aggressively move over to their box, hit that volley, and then your partner is gonna have to, wait for it, slide to the left. And then they are gonna occupy the spot that you were just taking. Please laugh.
Please clap.
And that's the drill. And then you're gonna keep repeating this where everybody gets a chance to be each position. Drill number 2 is a variation of drill number 1, but this time your partner is actually gonna start back on the baseline, and when the opponent tosses over a shot to your partner's side of the court, you're gonna decide whether or not you wanna go poach that shot from the net. If you do poach, your partner is gonna go from the baseline diagonally up to where you were just standing, and then you're gonna play the point out from there. Well, that wraps up another video on my channel. Thank you guys so much for the continued support. I really appreciate it. Huge shout out to Gearbox for sponsoring the channel and just continuing to support this journey. Let me know in the comments what you would like to see in any future videos, and I will see you all next week.